Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your favorite aesthetician again. And today we are talking about vitamin C serums, or rather antioxidants, what they do and the right time to use them. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Amaka and I talk skincare business and sometimes just random stuff. Well, I've not been saying a lot of random things. I've been doing more skincare, but we'll get there eventually. So yeah, today we're talking about vitamin C, antioxidants, what they do, and when we can use them. So why I'm doing this video is because I showed a routine on Instagram, a basic morning routine. And that routine, I cleansed, used a vitamin C serum, moisturized, and used a sunscreen. And I got a lot of comments around when vitamin C should be used. Some people were saying, no, it should not be used in the mornings, it should be used at night, it makes you more sensitive to the sun, yada, yada, yada. And of course, I educated them as to why vitamin C, not even why, because the explanation is very long, but I just explained that no, vitamin C actually should be used in the mornings. But in this video, no. I'm not giving my opinions yet. This video, we are addressing things from the foundation. Like I always believe with anything, not just skincare, for you to understand more about a topic or subject, you have to go to the foundation. Let's understand what exactly antioxidants do. Because vitamin C is primarily an antioxidant, one of the most potent there is. So now, let's get into the video. So let's understand what an antioxidant means. Anti is opposed to something, as in against something. So antioxidant means opposed to oxidant. What is an oxidant, or what are oxidants? Oxidant essentially means free radicals. Like free radicals are oxidants, oxidants are free radicals. Free radicals cause free radical damage, or what is also known as oxidative stress. This is the primary extrinsic cause of aging. And what I'm being specific is that aging is inevitable. Like they have intrinsic causes and extrinsic causes. So when you say intrinsic, you mean just nature. As you grow older, you age, your skin produces less collagen, skin cell turnover takes longer time. Things just happen as you age. That won't save day. But then there are extrinsic causes, things that, as a result of your environment, things that happen to your skin that speeds that aging process. Free radicals are the major culprit in extrinsic aging, things that make you age from the outside. Let's dive in a bit deeper as to how they actually operate and what are the causes of free radicals. So free radicals are molecules with an unpaired electron. Wait. Don't get confused, don't get worked up. You don't need to cram these terminologies. Just have an idea of how it works. So there are molecules with an unpaired electron. And electrons, and for a molecule to be stable, its electrons has to be paired. They work together in twos. Once an electron doesn't have its partner, it becomes unstable. And it goes about looking for electrons to pair with it. So your body has molecules, are made up of molecules, and all of them have paired electrons. They're all working as in optimally. They are working the way they are supposed to work. Everything is going on fine. Your lipids, your skin cells, your keratinocytes, everything is just happy. They are all have electrons that are paired. Then free radicals get into the mix. Now what happens is free radicals come with an unpaired electron. And I said every electron likes to be paired. So when they get into your skin, they need an electron to stabilize it. So they go about looking for where to steal electron from. They now grab an electron from a molecule that was functioning properly. It grabs an electron from it and pairs with its own electron to become stable. That molecule now becomes unstable because molecules need paired electron to be stable. That one becomes unstable and goes about looking for electron, takes electron from another molecule. That one becomes unstable. It now becomes an endless cycle of taking electrons from each other. Give me, I give it back. Give me, give me back. Give me, give me back. And these molecules cannot rest until they have a paired electron. You see, when that thing is happening, give me, I give you, that thing is called oxidation. That is the oxidative stress. That's the damage happening to your skin. That give me, I give you thing, ten, 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 give me, take it. Why they are playing that thing to more to more in your skin? And what is happening is that things that were working properly don't work properly anymore. And this causes irreparable permanent damage. So what's essentially happening is that the DNA of your skin is being affected, wrinkles and fine lines, inflammation, hyperpigmentation, cancer, name it, that your molecules are being broken down, scattered, destroyed, everything. Now for this to stop, as I said, molecules need their electrons to be paired. For this to stop, there has to be a molecule that can donate an electron and will not need to collect from another person. Somebody has to be the sacrificial lamb. Now this is where antioxidants come in. So antioxidants are molecules that remain stable even with an unpaired electron. So what happens is that they come in, they are complete though, all the electrons are paired. But then, even if you take an electron from them, they are still stable. They don't need to take from another person. And you need that to end that chain reaction. Like, because right now what's happening is everybody's taking and giving and taking and giving. You need somebody to give and not take. Antioxidants give and do not take. Now what that means is, if that is how they work, it means that they have to be there at the time free radicals are formed, so that they can give their electrons to this free radical before they take it from the molecules in your skin. Do you get? That's the only way antioxidants can actually prevent damage to the molecules in your skin. So next question is, when are free radicals formed? What are the causes of free radicals? So there are different causes of free radicals. Now, free radicals can be formed during natural biological process like breathing, respiration. However, for that one, you cannot control it. Do you get? Now we'll focus on external causes, things that be, to an extent we can control. So other things that cause free radical are smoking, pollution, and you know, the oga pata pata pata, ultraviolet rays, sun exposure. That is the oga pata pata. When you hear sun damages your skin, it's primarily because of free radicals. You see, free radicals start forming in your skin 15 minutes after sun exposure and keeps forming throughout the day, so far as you are exposed to the sun. And what the hell, even inside your house, free radicals are constantly being formed. That scary thing is that some ultraviolet rays, aka UVA, penetrate deep into your skin as far as the dermis. So if UVA can penetrate deep into your skin as far as the dermis, it means that that free radical damage can go as far as the dermis. You can imagine when this cascade of collect I collect, give I take is happening on that level. Imagine the degree and depth of skin damage that's going on. And normally our skin has antioxidants that fight for us. There's vitamin E, vitamin C, there's superoxide dismutase, there's catalase. Is it catalase? Wait, let me check. There's catalase. You know, the antioxidants are naturally, you know, in our skin that helps fight free radicals. However, a lot of times, like with most things in our skin, they need support, they need help. A lot of times, they're overwhelmed with these free radicals. There's pollution everywhere. You guys are smoking. There's sun exposure. They are breathing in things. Free radicals are just attacking your skin front, back, center, and they need support. You can introduce antioxidants in your life by either systemically, so things that you ingest, food, fruits, pills, or topically, things you apply on your skin. In my opinion, you could do both. Some people say that it's more effective when you consume antioxidant-rich foods and fruits. But I've seen a lot of research that also shows that it is less effective that way. Because when you ingest those things, they are digested, you know, excreted, and very little goes to the skin. I don't know which of these arguments is correct, but I would just say that most antioxidant-rich foods are also very healthy, so we have nothing to lose. Also, in line with that argument, they are, or people, proponents of this argument, are also of the opinion that applying antioxidants topically is a lot more effective because they get to work immediately and they just focus on the skin. I would say it doesn't hurt to have an antioxidant-rich diet. Your vitamin C's are okay. In addition, also incorporate antioxidants in your skincare. You know what I'm saying? So what are the antioxidants that actually work? Because they're see, you hear antioxidants front, back, and center everywhere. Before you say Jack Robinson, that ingredient is an antioxidant. It's okay. We understand that ingredients could have antioxidant properties, but what are the actual antioxidants that have been backed up with science and research? So you have things like superoxide dismutase, you have vitamin C, you have ferulic acid, you have green tea polyphenols. I'm always confusing that. You have green tea polyphenols, you have ferulic acid, you have vitamin E, you have so these are the ones like at top of mind. So other ones include coffeeberry, grapeseed extract, alpha lipoic acid, melatonin. In fact, there are plenty, but these are the ones that I just remember now. In fact, I'll list down like antioxidants, different types of antioxidants, so that you just look out for them in your product. Things to bear in mind when picking an antioxidant product. Now, the first thing is the antioxidants in the product have to be active up until when it's applied on your skin for it to actually work. You don't want a product that has like unstable antioxidants because they will not actually work. Also, they have to penetrate your skin in considerable amounts to be able to get in there and actually neutralize free radicals. Unfortunately, you can't know this by looking at the ingredient list. You just have to trust the manufacturers. And because fighting free radicals is very, icky. You can't really tell, because when you properly fight free radicals, what will happen is that your skin will not age as much. Dig it. So it's not something that you can see in the immediate. It's 5 years down the line, 10 years down the 10 years down the line. So you cannot really even tell if an antioxidant product is actually doing the job. That's just the funny thing about it. Dig it. But some pointers. I'll give you some pointers to bear in mind. Now, the first thing is maybe go with brands that have a track record of being reliable. At least you know that, at least this one, they know what they are doing. Do you get? Now, I'm not saying that you should not ignore upcoming brands, though. I'm just saying that if you wanted to tread on a safer side, that's a safer route to take. So go with brands that have a good reputation. That's one. Then two, look for a combination of antioxidants. Antioxidants are not standalones. Do you understand? More is actually more. They work synergistically. They work better together. The, more robust the product, it's not like they'll pack like a billion and one antioxidants, but the more robust the product, the more effective that it would be. Then also, there should be at least one, or two of the antioxidant that has been shown to really, really work. And these include vitamin C, vitamin E, ferulic acid, green tea polyphenols, superoxide dismutase. It should at least be this antioxidant present. Do you get? It's not like you just have like all these low working type of antioxidant plenty. You want at least a correct antioxidant in the mix. Also, they're opting for vitamin C, which is one of the most well-studied and robust. You would want to look out for things like ferulic acid and what's the third one? And vitamin E, because studies have shown that this combination together not only stabilizes the vitamin C, but also boosts its efficacy. Then also, if you're opting for vitamin C again, vitamin C is very unstable and it gets oxidated easily, so it reacts with light. It is preferable if you opt for vitamin C in an airless tight pump. It just helps preserve the vitamin C better. So now to the ultimate question. When is the right time to use a vitamin C serum or an antioxidant serum? I want you to answer that question yourself. Is it in the mornings, before your sunscreen, before you step out of the house, before free radicals form, so as to intercept free radical damage. As the free radical is forming immediately, it's donating an electron to calm it down and tell it, no, leave my molecules alone. Is that the right time to use an antioxidant serum? Or is it at night? After a full day of free radical party on your skin, you now apply an antioxidant serum. I'm guessing to do what? To repair the damage? I don't know. You answer. No. But yeah, I mean, it's not totally useless applying an antioxidant serum at night. But in my opinion, considering the way antioxidants work, they work to prevent free radicals from tampering with your skin. They have to be present at the time the free radicals are formed. And UV exposure is one of the major causes of free radicals in your skin. Do you now understand? Anyway, if you have a contrary opinion, please leave your comments in the comment section. I would love us to engage on this further. That brings us to the end of this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye.